This is a production of PBS 39.
Our next story will tickle your taste buds. A local chef cooked up quite a creation at a recent competition, earning him the title of Pennsylvania's preferred best chef. Alice Massimi takes us to Emmaus for more.
Meet Pennsylvania's preferred best chef, Michael Adams. He runs the show at the farmhouse in Emmaus. He sizzles as chef and co-owner. Judges say he stirs up the best food in the state of Pennsylvania.
So at this time, it gives me great pleasure to announce the winner of the first Pennsylvania Preferred Best Chef program, Michael Adams from Farmhouse Restaurant.
Growing up, Michael spent tons of time watching his mother and father cook in the kitchen.
His dad was a creative person. He would invent recipes and do different things, especially with grilling. And basically, I was a baker, and I would have Michael sitting on the counter in his little infant seat, and I'd be kneading bread. And he was very content to sit there. I figured he liked the smell.
As Michael grew up and outgrew the infant seat, he continued to spend his time in the kitchen, watching and learning from his parents.
My mother actually encouraged me to write down my dreams as a child. And when I was 8, I had a dream that I was going to become a chef and own restaurants one day.
He followed that dream. After he graduated from high school, he attended the prestigious Culinary Institute of America in Hyde Park, New York.
The best culinary school, and may still be. So I wanted to go to the best school.
After graduation, Michael ate at the farmhouse. Impressed by the food, he applied and was quickly hired.
He was working as a sous chef, and our head chef left. And the head chef said, he's up to the job, even though he'd only been doing it for about a year.
Little pomegranate molasses for the marmalade.
His sister Chris also works at the farmhouse.
Tom from Happy Farm Call.
Yeah.
He said he'll be dropping off your order of chickens for tomorrow.
Managing the restaurant, Chris hears compliments from customers and says Michael's delectable dishes earn high praise.
Good is a rare comment. It's usually, you know, incredible, fantastic. Wonderful meal.
What makes Mike a great chef is that he cares about the customer. I've had a number of chefs in here who care more about their food than they do about the people coming in the door.
You're touching and you're smelling and you're seeing these gorgeous plates go up and you're listening to the sound of something searing in a pan and like all of those things and being in that and smell, it makes you feel good. It's like magical when you find out at the end of the day, every customer was like raving. It's like the best feeling in the world. And there isn't a day that I ever wake up and I'm like, oh, I got to go in today.
Michael passes that passion on to others.
We'll have the rack of pork. We'll have the confit.
I was doing dishes, watching Pops. And he always asked me for little things to do, like size. Can you peel these? Can you do this? So he say, oh, it seems like you amok real quick, and then he likes the way that I want to work. So he sees something else on me that I could do, and then say, I want you to teach you how to cook.
Since then, they've become an inseparable team. Working side by side, they anticipate each other's next move.
I would say 98% that what I know I learned from him. The best thing that I know is from him.
Michael doesn't just cook for his customers. On this morning, we caught up with Michael, his mother, and sister, eating a family favorite, a baked apple pancake.
What kind of apples did you use?
Actually, I used Empire State.
Anne's pleased with Michael's recent win at the Pennsylvania Farm Show.
I'm proud of Michael all the time. I'm proud of the person he is, not just because he has a success. I'm proud of him because he's a good person. He has impeccable integrity, and he's a kind person.
When he's not in the kitchen, he spends time with his 17-year-old son, Dustin, hiking.
Spending time with my son, amazing guitar player. So just sitting at home and gives me goosebumps to hear him.
Michael says he's found the right recipe for life, a dash of family, a spoonful of fun, and a generous helping of friends. For Tempo, I'm Alice Massimi reporting.